first night was a nightmare, terrible, and I was so afraid of entering people's car, I don't know. I was crying throughout the night.
Piano piano, ho iniziato a capire che era bella ma anche schiava.
I came as a slave, but now I help the victims of trafficking.
All the girls have some debts to pay, and the debts are much, from 25,000 euros up to 50,000 euros before they are free.
Se ci sono degli eroi in queste storie, gli eroi sono le donne che sono le nostre ospiti.
Exciting because I come to meet new people and sometimes it helps me while I wear my pain.
A quaint village in northern Italy is an unlikely location for a Nigerian disco. Once trapped, these girls are now free.
When you laugh, you dance, you are happy. You can never be old. You cannot be sick.
They're all here thanks to Princess, a former sex slave from Africa.
My name is Princess Inya. I'm from Akwa Ibom State, Nigeria. I came here Italy about 13 years ago. I came as a slave, but now I help the victims of trafficking.
Another place here.
And there's a girl there.
Yeah, there's a girl there by the left.
On the left.
When we passed before, she was not there. That means it just.
Across Italy, roads like these hide a dark secret. You don't have to look hard to see dozens and dozens of girls working. Most are sex slaves, tricked and trafficked from Africa to Europe. Sold for tens of thousands of dollars.
The girl is inside the car.
She's in the car?
Yeah.
Oh, she is too.
Dotted all over, chairs. A sign as sex slaves on duty. Princess once walked these streets and knows how brutal it is.
See another one here by
another,
this side.
On the left?
Yeah, by the left.
This man's just zipping up his pants. Busy, it's rush hour around here.
Yeah.
She's now running a not-for-profit called PM. Her job is to check up on the girls and help those looking to escape their captors.
How many clients would they normally have in a day?
Sometimes, some said they have 5, some have 10, some have 15. Depends.
Are there many minors working on the streets?
Many, many now.
Many. What's the youngest?
15 years, 14 years.
15.
Most girls are from bitterly poor communities in Nigeria. They're promised well-paid jobs and a safer life, but are then forced into prostitution. Each of these girls represents a shattered dream.
They're hiding down there.
They're in the bushes? Ciao. Hi, how are you? Do you mind if I have a quick chat with you? What's your name?
I'm Sarah.
When you came here, how did you come here?
I came here with a foot.
Did you? How long did it take you to get here?
2 months.
I speak to some of the girls off camera. They tell me it isn't safe to show their faces.
So today I met a girl called Sarah who was walking up here on the roadside. This is her patch here. And when I was chatting to her, I realised that this is kind of where she hangs out when she's not waiting for clients up on the road. So generally, the clients will pull over in their cars. They will ask for some sort of a sexual act, ask for a price, for a quote, and then they'll negotiate from here. And what I realise is that this is kind of where she and her colleagues hang out when they're not up there. So you can see this is a fire that they obviously light at night to keep themselves warm. And there's a bunch of rubbish. And you can see there's a couple of lean-tos that they've kind of created, obviously for when they're trying to hide from the elements if it gets quite cold here because we're so close to the Alps.
The women work the streets here day and night, weekends and weekdays. In the past 3 years, there's been a 600% jump in the number of sex trafficking victims arriving in Italy by sea. They're part of the phenomenal wave of migration from Africa to Europe by boat. It's now the most deadly migrant route in the world. It's only when they arrive that they're told they owe astronomical sums of money. To their horror, their ticket to freedom becomes a trap into sex slavery.
All the girls have some debts to pay, and the debts are much, from 25,000 euros up to 50,000 euros before they are free.
At 5 euros per blowjob and as little as 15 euros for sex, it's almost impossible to pay off their debt. In the last 2 years, around 16,000 Nigerian women were forced into prostitution in Italy. This was Princess's story. She arrived 20 years ago, but she'll never forget the things that happened to her.
So after 1 week in the house, two women came to buy girls. She bought me at the sum of $13,000. And then she told me I would pay 50. So it was terrible and dangerous work, you know, because most of the time I met people that were bad people, that they were killers, you know. They kill girls for fun. The first night was a nightmare, terrible, and I was so afraid of entering people's car, I don't know. I was crying throughout the night.
And then Princess's life took another unexpected turn.
Were there any clients that you saw regularly that you really liked?
Yeah, there were some. Like,
is there any in particular? Is there one in particular?
Yeah, there was one from Iceland.
Ciao, Alberto.
Oh, ciao.
Buonasera.
Ciao. Welcome.
Tutto bene?
And the second one was Alberto, which became my husband.
Ma non ero da solo. E ho visto passando questa bella ragazza sulla strada, mi sono fermato e ho detto vieni al mare con me. Qui siamo salita, siamo stati 2 giorni insieme, ci siamo conosciuti e poi da lì è andata avanti tutta la frequentazione.
How long have you been married?
13 years, no?
13 years. When am I princess? I did a big mistake. Because it's African culture. If you marry one, you don't marry one. You marry all the tribe. You have to provide for all the tribe.
Quando hai conosciuto che sei innamorato con Princess?
Innamorato è una parola grossa. Ho iniziato a essere molto interessato a Princess, un po' per lei, ma anche per tutto il mondo che lei si portava dietro. L'Africa, la Nigeria, il mondo della prostituzione. Poi nel tempo, con la frequentazione, allora è arrivato anche l'amore. Ma quando abbiamo iniziato a parlare, iniziato a vedere, capire che non c'era qualcosa che non funzionava. non era solo bella, sì, era molto bella, era ficcarmi contro la raffica. Piano piano ho iniziato a capire che era bella ma era anche schiava.
Princess and Alberto began secretly dating, raising money to pay off her debts, freeing her from slavery.
You want to taste this one?
Who's the better cook, Alberto? You or
Alberto is a good princess. Cook. I'm a good cook. But man, I didn't come.
Like so many sex slaves trapped here, Princess left her children behind in Nigeria. Her eldest son has now joined her in Italy.
Bravo, Alberto!
Princess and Alberto also have a young daughter together.
How long was it in between seeing your children?
It was about 5 years. Yeah, it was very hard for them. They couldn't get the good attention as a motherly attention or love. It was not the same.
Tu prendi un po' di yam, lo metti dentro il bagnetto, mangi quello afro-piemontese.
Tutto due.
No, abbiamo provato con uno chef qua di Asti.
Sì.
E lui fa queste cose adesso.
Davvero?
È una roba che va bene. Quello con questo è un giusto mix.
Un po' di misto?
Sì.
Instead of turning her back on her past, Princess is trying to help other girls who are caught in the same trap.
Ciao, buonasera, ciao beauty, sono Maggie. Ciao, grazie.
Thanks for having me.
Princess and her team have rescued more than 250 girls. Beauty's one of them. Beauty, or Beauty One, as she's known, lives here with her friends, Beauty Two and Tina. After 2 years in Italy, Beauty's made this her home.
Yours?
Yeah, they are mine. I saw them in the market and I love the colors. So I got them for Valentine. Okay, welcome to my bedroom.
Nice.
This is my favorite one.
Oh, what is it?
They call it lace. It's for a very expensive occasion.
So how would you wear this in Nigeria? Okay.
I have to put it around your waist.
You put it around my waist, okay.
Yeah,
so
yeah.
What did you do in Nigeria before you came to Italy?
Hairdressing.
You did?
Yeah, yeah.
Wow.
I'm from a polygamous home.
You're from a polygamous home?
Yeah. My dad with 19 children.
19 children?
Mm-hmm. Mm. And 4 wives. This is the only one I have left.
Beauty was trafficked from Nigeria to Italy by boat, alone. She never saw her mother again.
Before she died, she told me, my child, whatever you see in life, take it as your fate, don't give up. She told me be very strong because I, your mother, is very strong. I never gave up on you.
Can you explain for people who don't understand, who don't know that most of the girls on the streets are sex slaves. Can you explain to them what that's like for you, living with that?
First of all, the most terrible part of it was when I was on my period. I had to take a very thick piece of rag and put inside of me. Sorry. So the men could go penetrate through me without seeing the blood. Just imagine the pain. You pushing that tissue inside your womb. It's so painful, all because of, sometimes you don't even get 20 euro. You have to pay, they tell you 15 euro. And sometimes they even sex you, the money they paid you, they still gotta beat you and collect the money with so much pain.
B2 Beauty and the other girls I spoke to all said that they and their parents had no idea what would happen to them in Italy. But Alberto tells a very different story. He says the parents knowingly send their girls to a life of prostitution and slavery.
Sì, ormai quasi tutte sanno. Sanno. Quello che non si sanno tanto sono poi le condizioni. Cioè la gente, tanti di queste ragazze pensano andrò a fare anche la prostituzione in Europa. Ma magari pensano di andare in grandi hotel, in casino a Las Vegas dove c'è gente ricca, tanti soldi, uomini che fanno dei regali, no, un po' come attrici dello spettacolo. Non sanno che andranno sulla strada a prostituirsi per 5 euro con chiunque e saranno picchiate. I clienti, lo sfruttatore, i trafficanti, la riduzione in schiavitù, la polizia che fa le retate, le ragazze che scappano, è tutto un mondo molto... tanta roba all'intorno.
Human trafficking is the world's fastest growing criminal enterprise. Its illegal profits making an estimated 200 billion Australian dollars globally every year.
Le ragazze sono quelle, sono il primo step di questa grossa mafia nigeriana. Perché le ragazze nigeriane in questo grosso sistema di criminale sono il primo step, sono cash flow.
When the Nigerian mafia work alongside the Italian mafia, it's an almost impenetrable criminal network.
Gli strumenti quali sono? Sicuramente sono la superstizione del voodoo, facendo comunque un rito magico in cui le ragazze giurano in un santuario, in una cerimonia pagana, di impegnarsi a rispettare i propri trafficanti, la propria madame, se non moriranno oppure la propria famiglia avrà sventure, morte e dolori.
With very few victims willing to testify against the Nigerian mafia, the slave trade looks set to continue. Despite the Vatican and the Pope declaring eliminating it a key priority in this Catholic heartland. Princess's work never stops. She's back patrolling the streets with her anti-trafficking team, trying to save others.
Hello. Hello, baby girl.
Come
near. But please use condom.
Before you know it, you don't catch sickness. HIV, you don't know where will be who. So you have to use condom always.
On a rain-soaked train platform in Asti, the latest rescue arrives. Queen has been walking the streets as a sex slave in central Italy for 2 years.
Buongiorno. Come state?
Bene.
Okay, Queen. You are welcome.
Thank you.
We can't show her face because she fears her traffickers will recognise and possibly harm her. Accompanying Queen is Fatima, whose role is to help the survivors transition to a new life.
In this house, there are rules and regulations. One, we don't fight. This is your room, this is your bed. This is where you are going to stay. Hello, girls.
Queen will be sharing this two-bedroom unit with five other rescued girls.
This is your roommate. She is called Tessie. And she is called Lovette.
I vow to God, I will never go back to street again.
Queen left behind her seven-year-old son. Her mum and her sister died recently. This is her family now.
Precious. Are you ready?
Yes, just to get ready.
All the girls are given a safe house and money for food. But there are strict conditions. They have to follow the rules and promise not to work on the streets. In fact, they can't work anywhere until their residency papers are finalised.
Okay, here we are.
So they hang out, they study Italian, and they go through job training.
This is going to burn out that fat on your waist.
Praying that their visas will come through to open up the next phase in their life. Princess did more than help Beauty get off the streets. She helped her rebuild her life and her skills.
Mommy.
I love them so much. And these smiles on my face are because of her.
Do you work in the kitchen too?
Yes.
Were you there where they make this?
Yeah.
Good.
She's my boss. And when I came here, I met her and she told me, I like this one. I want her to work with me. See? And this is Ray. She's my worker too. I feel happy, encouraged that I could work here with white people, which I never dreamt of. So exciting.
And how much money are you making here?
When it's converted to Nigerian money, it's high. It's high. Better off what we used to see when we walk in the street.
A lot of the other girls haven't got jobs yet, or still aren't allowed to work. They say Beauty's lucky, or making her own luck.
Are you proud of her to see her working here? What do you think?
Of course, yeah, we're so happy seeing her working. And at least other girls seeing her working might be encouraged, no?
When I came here, I never thought there was gonna be an opportunity to work, because the belief was like there is no hope for people like us here. We thought it was all gonna be in the street, in the street, in the street. But when we met her, they had to make things change for us, and now I'm working. I'm like a normal person here. All thanks to them.
Everyone say, Jesus,
Princess. Do I look a little different now?
You look beautiful, fantastic, and the rest of that.
Are you serious?
Yeah.
And you think I'm gonna get a new boyfriend today?
Yeah.
These days, instead of getting dressed to work the streets, Beauty and her friends are getting ready to have fun.
Let's go, I can't wait. Why do they sound like this?
I came to Italy knowing I'd be meeting human trafficking victims. I thought I'd leave overwhelmed by the tragedy of it all. But instead, here I found a story of resilience and transformation. Beauty, Princess, and the others don't want to be defined by their past.
I want to be a source of joy to people. I want to be like Princess.
They feel lucky to be rebuilding their lives, and they're going to give this second chance everything they've got.
Oh, my dream is, if I wish, we can make the trafficking in human beings stop. And I can help all the victims in the streets to liberate them from their depression. Because I believe that most of them have things in their mind, but they don't have someone to talk to. How I wish I can let them know that we are there to serve them.